Ruins of an ancient civilization, sun-kissed beaches, scenic islands scattered like gems in the sea, incredible landscapes, delicious cuisine, and friendly atmosphere. All these things make Greece one of the most visited countries in Europe. In this video, we will share a tour guide to this beautiful European country from India, where we will discuss the top places to visit here, how to get the visa, where to stay, what to eat, local transports, how to reach there, and the best time to visit. The visa. All Indian citizens need a Schengen visa for visiting Greece. To get the visa, first you will have to submit a duly filled visa application form and some other documents mentioned there along with the visa charge. The processing time for Greece visa will be around 15 days. How to reach? You will get flights to the capital of Greece, Athens, from New Delhi. There will be one to two stops in between. Mostly, you can go to Greece via Abu Dhabi, Istanbul, or Turkey. To minimize your flight charge, do check the fares first and then decide the route where the charge is minimum. The best time to visit. The best time to visit Greece is from April to September, when you can enjoy all the outdoor activities and water sports. The tour. Day 1. On the first day of your tour, you will reach Athens Airport from India. From the Athens Airport, the city center is around 42 kilometers and it will take around 50 minutes to 1 hour to reach the city center from the airport. There is local taxis available to take you to city center from the airport, which charges around 38 euro. Day 2. On the second day, you can go to visit the local sites of Athens. The top tourist attractions that you should not miss here are Acropolis. Your visit to Athens will be incomplete unless you visit to this famous hill, which literally stands on top of Athens. This is a landmark of the city and many of the ancient ruins are located here. Parthenon. Parthenon is the most famous building in Athens. Standing majestically on top of the Acropolis mountain, this temple is dedicated to goddess Athena, the patron of Athens, to thank her for protecting Athens during the Persian War. Ancient Agora. Located northwest of the Acropolis, the ancient Agora of Athens was an ancient marketplace and civic center where people gathered to meet others and talk about politics, business, current events, and the nature of the universe and divine. Agoraios Kolonos. It is the temple of Hephaistos and was built in the 5th century BC. Erechtheum. Located on the Acropolis, Erechtheum was an ancient sanctuary dedicated to Athena Polias, Erechtheus, and Poseidon. Temple of Olympian Zeus. It is the largest temple in Greece dedicated to Zeus Olympios. The temple is in ruins now and you can only see 15 out of 104 huge columns. Today it reminds us the past glory of Greek history. Odeon of Herodes Atticus. It is a top music venue in Athens. Built by Herodes Atticus in memory of his wife, this amphitheater could accommodate more than 6,000 people. It is located at the base of the Acropolis. Panathenaic Stadium. In ancient time, the stadium hosted a religious festival dedicated to the goddess Athena, held every 4 years. At present, 50,000 spectators can sit here and it is the largest marble-made stadium in the world. Monastiraki. It is a huge marketplace from where you can collect souvenirs. Day 3. On the third day of your tour, go to visit Mykonos from Athens. You can avail both flight and ferry to reach Mykonos from Athens, of which ferry is the cheaper option but will take longer time. The ferry will take around 2.5 to 3 hours to reach Mykonos and the ticket price will be around 70 to 80 euros depending on the position of the seat. With its picturesque beaches, crystal clear blue water, milky white buildings, Mykonos is like a paradise on earth. At present, the place is a regular stop for world's largest cruise ships. Day 4. On the fourth day, visit the top attractions of Mykonos, which are Little Venice Quarter. Little Venice Quarter is situated on the western edge of Kora near Elephantra Beach. It is a section of Mykonos where the buildings are situated right at the edge of the sea and is the most scenic place in the island. Delos. Delos Island is the birthplace of Apollo and Artemis in Greek legend. Delos is uninhabited and you can get ferries that take you there from Mykonos where you can explore the ruins. Kartomeli. The 16th century windmills are among the most popular attractions in Mykonos. Today, the preserved windmills have been converted to the museum and there are currently 16 windmills on Mykonos, of which 7 are situated on the famous landmark hill in Kora. Paradise Beach. Your trip to Mykonos will be incomplete without a visit to Paradise Beach. It is one of the most popular party spots in all of Greece and home to the island's largest nightclub. Elia Beach, the longest beach on Mykonos, less crowded and a quiet beach where you can enjoy water sports. Panagia Paraportiai, it is a historic religious site of Mykonos. The Milky White Seaside Church is most popular for its unique shape and unusual construction. Day 5. On the 5th day, go to another beautiful Greek island, Santorini, from Mykonos by ferry. During 16th century, the Santorini island was ruined due to a volcanic activity and now it is revived as a gorgeous natural island. Its rugged landscape, romantic solitude, beachside resorts by the Aegean Sea, Kamari and Perisa offer countless water activities for the entire family. Day 6. On the 6th day, go to visit the tourist attractions of Santorini. The main places to visit here are Caldera. It is the world's only submerged caldera, 1,000 feet over the sea level, and the principal attraction among the places to visit in Santorini. Perisa Beach. This stunning black sand beach is one of the top places to see in Santorini. Oia. The most stunning village on this island and the best places to see in Santorini. Thrasia. This is one of the most unspoiled places to visit in Santorini. This volcanic island presents nature at its purest. Day 7. On the 7th day, head back to Athens for departure. If you have time in hand, then you may visit two other beautiful places here. These two places are Zagori and Meteora. At Zagori, you can see the Vykos Gorge or Vykos Canyon, which is listed as the world's deepest related to its width gorge by the Guinness Book of Records. The Greek word Meteora means suspended in the air, and this word aptly describes the mighty over 1,200 feet high cliffs here. The most inspiring structures on these cliffs are the historic monasteries suspended along the summits. Where to stay? In all the above places like Athens, Mykonos and Santorini, there are lots of hotels and hostels available with different budget range. You may also book an Airbnb apartment which will cost less than a hotel room. Generally, hotel room will cost around 100 to 120 euros per day. All these properties have online booking facilities and I will share the online booking links in the description box below. Food. Almost all the hotels provide complimentary breakfast here. You will mostly get authentic Greek food like pies, salads, yogurt, and tea or coffee here. The budget. Almost all the tour operators in India provide Greece tour packages as this is one of the most commonly visited European locations. The package will generally cost between 40 to 80,000 including food, accommodation and local transfers. You can book these packages online and I will share the links in the description box below. But please remember that the charges may vary. If you love this tour plan, then please like and share the video. Also, do let us know your opinion in the comment section below. Your opinion means a lot to us. Thanks for watching it.